Hello everyone, my name is Teriprism, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer Chaos Campaign. Today's episode main goal for me will be taking out this dwarf settlement now that it doesn't have so big of army, but at same time I'm thinking of taking out this or finishing of this army that we beat in last episode trying to ambush us. So let's just start by attacking that orc army. Or maybe not. Looks like I didn't have enough moves left. So let's see. Next, technology research. I'm thinking of going with. I could afford this unholy communion, but I think I rather go first with the erection of ruinous monuments, since that gives us 20% extra from sacking settlements. Income, I mean. Tributes and monuments to the dark powers ensure the Chaos God's favor. Not sure if I want to keep this technology here otherwise, since this seems just mainly for marauders, and I'm going to drop them as soon as I'm able to. Anyway, let's just end this turn here. Oh, right, I should give her skill points. So, I'm thinking of going with one of these here, but which one? Or, yeah, I'm going with a deadly blade, increased melee attack. Alright, I just check out if he has any new items I can equip. It doesn't look like it. It's been a while since last time I recorded, so that's why I'm double checking these. Anyway, let's just end this turn here. Well, there goes that chance of taking out that dwarf settlement easily. So what are we gonna actually expect from here? Yeah, this that's not looking so good. But there's that army incoming there, but I think I'm back away for a moment and set up a camp to heal up my army and then continue from there. We might also be able to build something useful. Alright, we lack that growth. But I could get if I wait two turns I can start building something. So, or can I actually? No, I really can't, since I need at least four points to build something. So let's check out. I could get two more units of something, but what do I need? What do I really need? Well, since we are going against the dwarves, I'm definitely need something with armor piercing, and maybe two units of these horsemen with the throwing axes. Yeah, let's take those. and
slaughtering your name. Never. What?
I'm thinking of sending him to this province here to spread corruption here.
Never stop. Glory away.
Let's start by dropping that. Public order of this province here. Can I recruit another hero? Not yet, but Lord. I need the extra population surplus for that. But I think recruiting another lord and getting a second army could be really useful. At least if I lose this army, I won't be losing the whole game straight away then. Anyway, let's just end this turn here. Well, that became a slightly bit too easy now. I'd be a fool for not taking that opportunity there. Did that... I think they did. They just went and took that settlement right under my nose there. That's not good for me, but there's that stray dwarf army I might be able to take out. But who was it? It's scaling army.
No.
Okay. Well, let's just end this turn once more.
Okay.
And yeah, you'll just stay there. And he's running away. Just great. Let's just finish this off, and since this is a so easy fight, I will be just skipping this actual fighting, since not much fun to watch me just curb stomp them, right? Let's just give this to there and start this battle. I'll be right back. And welcome back. That fight was, like I said, really easy. I didn't lose any soldiers there. So, nothing really fun to show you. Anyway, let's just sack this settlement, since I need extra money, and I know it was it's a really low amount, but I still every bit counts this time. So let's just track that. Oh, we got collector. Some nobles of the mortal nations, the rich ones, take to buying antiques and cursed items. Their ignorance is in unearthing such relics is our ally. Little bit of extra income from sacking settlements in future. That's good. But I'm not going to stop with just that. I will be raising that settlement down on next turn. So let's just end this one here. Well, they took down that another dwarf settlement there, and I'm thinking of, instead of me sacking this one straight away, I'll be going for that main settlement there, and try to sack that first, and then come back and raise that one there. That sounds like a good idea, at least to me. But first, let's recruit that lord, so we can have two armies going on, and I won't be so easily defeated. Chaos Sorcerer Lord. Could be useful, but do I want a blind one? Not really. Thousand seems quite good choice considering military heritage. But do I want the lore of death for my magic? Or lore metal one? But him being stupid doesn't sound good idea. And Archaon can kind of do fire already, so I'm going with this thousand dead dealer. Getting that dead lore going on. And let's take out you out of that stance. And keep some of my troops for him. Two Warhounds, just this basic marauder horsemen, and those about 6 troops for him. I'm not giving up my Chaos Warriors, since I'm going to need them, but let's just hope he can deal with those. Now I need to move Archaon away from there to avoid that attrition from there. Now let's head straight there. And camp up next turn.
I foresee destruction.
And looks like we're on negative income at the moment, so this will be interesting. Okay. But now we need to get you, or maybe, yeah, I'm going to go with straight on attack with Archaon here. Oh, it's it has falls there. Actually, I'm going to break this siege right away, because I need to raise up my army a little bit before I'm comfortable assaulting that place. And for that, I need to get a few more of these marauders that have great weapons. There we go. And I will be using this army here to gather some money for me. But before that, I'm going to get some new troops for him too. two Marauder units there, and then let's see if I can build something. Nothing really, but I'm going to get this one once he has enough points for new, or enough growth to for me to get this one here. Yeah, let's end this turn here now. Oh dear. That wasn't good. Well, my own fault completely there. Let's see. This one, I might be able to get some good, interesting battle foods from here, but if it's a clearly one-sided fight like I'm guessing it will be, I will be cutting this off. And like you saw, that didn't go so well, so yeah, I wasn't expecting to survive that, but I just wish I did some more extra damage there, but oh well, can't really help it. Oh, don't finish him off. Yeah. Yeah, he won't survive this. First, dead lord here. Well, I'll quickly fight this and be right back. Yeah, that was just massacre there. Well, I lost my second arm. That's not good. Oh well. And we got mission. The Dwarven Mountain Realms are ready for ravaging. Begin the harvest. That's going to be really easy. I just need to raid the place I'm currently located at. So, won't be too hard then. Let's just switch our stance to raiding. And that should do it. Let's just end it here. And there's some pieces made and wars declared. And Archaon gained the rank. I'm thinking of going with the Flaming Sword of Ruin, or actually, let's go with Kindle Flame, making enemy weak to fire. Fire with fire, two blazes together are stronger and hotter than two apart. The Kindle Flame intensifies such fire. That sounds good. But I'm thinking of going for this settlement in here now. Or yes, I'm going to go there. Let's build some siege towers here and then a battering ram. Actually, let's make this way, so we can get in faster if we needed to. Going to continue that siege for a few turns until I can get inside and then fight that siege battle. quest issued, the Slayer of Kings. The Well Gods of Chaos ask for total and complete devotion from their followers, and they grow strong upon the conflict and bloodshed they unleash. In exchange, the ruinous powers offer their champions dark blessings, gifts that make the faithful mighty indeed. For the chosen few, whose heaped sacrifices draw the gaze of their patrons time and again, no reward, not even that of immortality, is beyond their grasp. Yet Archaon's destiny drives an ambition higher still, and as his power grows ever greater, it demands a war shrine to focus the gaze of the Dark Gods upon him above all others. Ensure that following building has Chaos War Shrine. Okay, didn't I already build one? I'll have to check out... Nope. Apparently I didn't. Is it this one? Nope. Was it the Archaon? Yeah, I need to get this building change built here. That's going to take some time. How's my... Two more turns then I can go. Let's end that turn there. Not much to do at the moment, especially after they destroyed my second army.
The Eye of Sirion has already told me your offer, but I will hear it from your lips all the same.
Archaon? I'll be honest with everyone. I don't want to take this peace treaty, but... Actually, it's just the opposite. I want to take this peace treaty, but I also want to play Archaon as I think he would play. And... he's not one to agree on peace. But on other hand, he isn't stupid either. Let's see if I can ask some payment from... Just a small payment there. I can actually increase that. That's too much, but maybe... Nope. How about... ...600. No. Well, let's go with that then. I can't really focus on that tribe and everyone else too here. So... especially with the third dwarf army incoming. I'm actually thinking of going... with just this. But then I wouldn't be having my... these troops... inside then. Yeah, I'll have to wait one more turn before assaulting. I need that gate opened. And I'm not sure if I can do that with just those chaos spawns. Well, we are going against that army soon enough. But first, who are you? Chaos Rebel Uprising. Ah, that's good for us, I think. But now, it's time to assault this set... and assault this settlement and fight this siege battle. Let's check out what kind of... defenses we are going to expect. Looks like we are going in from left side. So let's just fight this battle here. Okay, I'm going to try something different. This part actually will be... This commentary here will be recorded after I've done this actual battle. And yeah, so let's just get on it. So, I will be facing garrison troops of dwarves. And there will be three longbirds. Kind of like their main infantry force, then two units of thunderers, and two units of quarrelers and miners. I'm most worried about thunderers, so I'm focusing on this left gate and preparing to face those thunderers, since they are riflemen and their weapons puncture through armor, so I'm going to use my marauders as first line of attack. But I'm in trouble if enemy is going to use quarrelers here. So I'm preparing my troops here, mainly putting my marauders in front, especially those marauders on horses, since they can also shoot back, or actually throw their axes, and they are armor-piercing too. Most of my marauders are armor-piercing marauders, except for one squad that I assigned to Battering Ram. And my Chaos Warriors, only two of them have armor-piercing capabilities, but I will be hoping to use them against the longbeards mostly, so that won't be so bad. And I was really lucky, because enemy, or those dwarves, chose to put their thunderers all on other gate, so I could approach quite easily. I only got a fire from those towers and bit fire from quarrels a bit later on. Though, because I chose to use my marauders in front, I took quite heavy losses on them because of that. My warhounds will be mostly useless in this fight, because they are not very good against armored units. Anyway, as you can see, I put my marauder units in front, followed by line of Chaos Warriors. And in back, I have my Chaos Spawns and Warhounds here. And on this wall, or this gate, enemy has one unit of Miners and one unit of Longbeards on the wall. And right behind that gate, there is another Longbeards unit. And in back, there is that Quarrelers unit I was taking a little bit of extra fire from. And I was trying to get the Archaon to use his Burning Head on that Quarrelers unit. At this moment, I kind of forgot I couldn't put it on walls, but I soon set it back on those Quarrelers. And I'm about to have my siege towers dock the wall, so let's zoom in. And my marauder units with the great weapons will be really useful here, since they can penetrate the dwarven heavy armor quite well. But since they are not very heavily armored themselves, they will be also taking quite a lot of beating here. But despite that, for some reason, dwarves decided to only attack my right side siege tower, allowing me to complete free reign through that left siege tower, and I could get few troops downstairs quite easily. Here I'm just pouring my troops in through those siege towers and sending more troops in. I was thinking of sending Archaon from here up, but since my battering ram is so close, I decided to instead leave him down here and wait for a door to open. And instead I sent both to my marauders on the right side, so I could more easily punch through dwarven armor. At this point I noticed the dwarves brought up their thunder unit from Otter Gate, and I sent one of my marauder units to stop them from shooting my chaos spawn at the back, that are still waiting for a door to open. I should have moved them closer to the gate and not keep them so far away, since those towers will keep shooting at them, and I took quite a bit of losses from that, because I left them so back. At this moment I'm trying to utilize my last few marauder horsemen units here to help out with those thunderers up on the walls, but they're quite depleted at this stage and age. And I finally broke through the main gate, and I chose to send Archaon through, and I was trying to get the Burning Head through here, but it was too close. But as you can see, Archaon was quite a beast in melee itself, just sending those dwarves flying, and I chose to then move my other units on flank and send the rest of my infantry I haven't yet got on wall through that gate, including my Warhounds and Chaos Spawns. And that was actually... I was trying to get see if I can do some damage with the fireball in close range, but that was kind of failure there. And as you can see, I only now just sent those Warhounds and Chaos Spawn in. I'm not expecting much from my Warhounds here, but I was especially looking forward to those Chaos Spawns as they pack quite a bunch here. I was mainly focusing on this commanding Longbeard unit down here and trying to surround it and finish it off completely, including buffing my Chaos Warriors in there. And you're going to be seeing quite well how strong these Chaos Spawns are. They just easily send this dwarf flying back in frame. At this point I was considering completely routing my marauder units, since they mostly did their jobs, but I actually decided later on to bring them back, and that was a kind of mistake on my part. I'm having a little bit of trouble on the wall, since dwarves are really strong holding the line, and there's just basically one frontliner over there, but I decided to try to flank with one of Chaos Warriors units and try to maneuver it behind those dwarves in on that wall, and I think I succeeded at that, but it took a little while. I managed to get a few of those dwarven units routed, and that helped a little bit, but still I needed to do plenty of buffing up my army here to keep them just to deal enough damage on those dwarves while I maneuvered my one unit of Chaos Warriors behind them. At this point I was thinking that was all of those dwarves, and I decided to send one unit of Warhounds and one unit of Marauders I still had left to capture that square and make sure I get this sooner than later, but it actually turned out to be a little bit of a mistake, since there's a two units of dwarves defending it, and I wasn't able to see them, and I got distracted by managing this fight here, especially this, sending this warriors unit on back side of these dwarves here. And I kind of work to few of my units, especially at the left side of this wall, of quite a long time, and they just didn't do anything. And here you can see they had one Quarrelous unit and one Thunderer unit here, ready to face off against my Marauder Horsemen and Warhounds, which they routed. At this moment I didn't even notice it until a little bit later on here. And I was preparing these troops. At this moment I noticed that they had those troops actually back there. And at that moment I sent the rest of my Marauders out. And I decided every unit I had down near gate and not on the walls, I will be sending towards that main square here, and was positioning them ready to face them. And thought I'd send Archaon and those Chaos Spawns through that frontal assault to distract them from that side. And my Warhounds were a bit too faster, and they just start to draw the enemy Quarrel's fire a bit too early, and I just had to retreat them for a little bit here. And I also had one spare Marauder unit going through front that I completely forgot about, but this is last few volleys they're sending on my charging troops, and they managed to take out few Marauders, but this Warhound's charge here completely finishes them off and routes the rest of dwarves I had anymore facing me here. So that fight was quite surprisingly easy, despite it being a close victory. And let's just end this battle here and see how much we gained from that assault there. Victory. Not bad amount of loot. Little bit XP. No magic items. And yeah, I'm definitely going to sack this first and then get that extra bonus from raising it next turn. Can you encamp? Good, because I'm going to need a few more troops here. These three of these great weapon Marauders. Here we go. Can I build anything? Nope, I still need the extra population surplus, but I can get new technology here, and I'm thinking of Unholy Communion. Once promise have been made, the champion is far along the road to damnation. Let's get that one. We should then be able to get some bonuses for our Chaos Warriors. That definitely will help out. But looking at the clock here, I think this is good place for me to end this episode. I will see you on next one. Goodbye!